This is Ritesh and you are watching Dancing with Data. So what I have for you today? Today we are going to talk about the toggle button. So maybe you would have noticed there are a lot of blogs where they are using parameter actions to create the same, but you don't need that. At least in my case, right? Improving the performance of your dashboard. The less the calculations are, the better the performance is. So let's talk about let's talk about the final destination. This is the beautiful toggle button. By default, I want to analyze my profit, and occasionally I want to see my sales, right? That means I have dragged my profit ratio to color over there, and here I have dragged my sales over there. So that's the motive, that's the destination, and let us see how we can do that. It's very simple. I think in fact this is the simplest way to create the toggle button, that too without using parameter actions. So we have these simple dashboard. Maybe we can take the total sales at the top, and after that profit map, where you have the profit ratio actually, and after that this is the sales map where I have dragged and dropped sales, so I can bring it over there. But remember one thing: before dragging this thing, this should be under either horizontal or vertical layout, right? So maybe I'll take vertical for this one. Here we go. Now remember that you need to hide the title. The title is hidden. And let me make it float, and that's the key. Before making this as a floating object, you will have to select it, because I'm making float, because you get the option with this only, right? So let me make this one as floating, right? So once I make the floating, then only I get the option to add show or hide button, right? But before that, what we need to do? We need to overlap these two maps, right? Then only it helps. That means That means this should sync, right? 8146, 824, and 646. For this also, it should be like sync. 8146. So again, remember that you'll have to select that container every time, right? It was 188, 146, right? 8 and 146. Here we go. That looks correct. But what about the width and height? 824 and 646. 824, 646. 646. Boom, exactly. Now we have got the option to show the add show and hide button. And if I just do alt click, boom, I'm almost there. But you want that lovely toggle button over there, right? So you can get it, you can just Google it, and I have downloaded a couple of images over there. So what I'll do, I'll just go to edit button. And after that, what do you want? When item is shown, what sort of pick you want? When item is hidden, what sort of pick you want? So it's up to you. So if this item is shown, then I should have this one. This one. Because this is a default image for me. And for the item hidden, we should have this one. Because when this is hidden, then I'm getting the main map. So this is as per my scenario. I can do it like this, Here we go. And maybe I can go to the presentation mode and show you. Boom. Isn't it cool? Cool. So I hope it helps. I would like to paste this very particular workbook as a public dashboard for you at my YouTube description, so that you can see that. And it's bye from Ritesh. Kyunki keep on dancing with data, kyunki data hi data hai kya tumko sab kuch aata hai.